So my name is Carsten Stöcker. So I'm working for Innogy in the Innogy Innovation Hub as a senior manager for our innovation program Machine Economy. And I'm now in the process of spinning off my own project and founding a new company called Spherity GmbH. There are a lot of digital twin solutions out in the market. It's basically the people who produce, manufacture components such as GE, Siemens or Bosch. They have their own proprietary digital twin solutions in the cloud and recording all kind of data about a single individual object they produce. However, when an object travels along the supply chain or value chain, is aggregated to a product, the product ownership in the product is transferred multiple times along the value chain, then it's very difficult to still have a connection between the component produced by GE and the product. Connection might disappear, and even the new product owner even doesn't want to have all the data in the cloud of GE. And for that reason, we are liberating the digital twins from proprietary cloud solutions, putting them in decentralized, blockchainified internet solution. And that's a very nice proposition, because when we do this, the identity and all the underlying data that are stored in the digital twin are under full control of the object, of the machine, or the owner of the machine in a very interoperable way with a full audit data trail to down when the data have been created, with a timestamp, with integrity, authenticity, and immutability of the data. And so very technical terms, but what does it mean? So for example, let's think about a car. So we have a digital twin of the car, telematics data. So we get the mileage, we get the consumption data, we get the usage data. If we have this data, we can bring an algorithm from insurance on top of the data. We can run usage-based insurance, which drives a lot of innovation for the insurance industry, without bringing all our data, let's say, in the cloud of insurance company. Then if an accident happens, then not only the insurance is involved, it's the fleet operators involved, the owners involved, the workshop fixing the car. And when they all have a data and even regulatory bodies are involved, and when all these entities have one single set of data with a full audit trail to when the data have been created, this accelerates, automates, and digitizes a lot of processes that are today very complex and manually, and this can be achieved with digital twins. So one example is smart meters. So we are putting smart meter data in digital twin. So what have we achieved them? First, we have a decentralized version of a smart meter database, which is under full control of the owner, let's say, of a household. Mm-hmm. Household. In addition, so when we get the data, let's say feed-in data from a solar cell, so we can create renewable energy certificates, which is basically a proof that energy was being produced by a solar cell and energy was not produced, let's say, by a coal-fired power plant. Mm-hmm. I think quantum computing is a new technology with huge, huge impact, and we don't even know about all the impact. It's an area where a lot of business innovation can happen. So as a utility, so we didn't go for kind of quantum computing, building our own computers. So we made up our mind what happens if quantum computers, or when quantum computers are available. So only a question of time. A lot of today's ciphers are vulnerable to quantum computing attacks. So which means we have to prepare ourselves. So what utilities deploy in the critical infrastructure today, including IoT, stays based on the experience for the next 30 to 40 years in the field. And for that reason, we have to think about post-quantum cybersecurity, to think about it today and to think about what can we do today or tomorrow to make sure that the devices we deploy are post-quantum secure, or at least updatable to make them post-quantum secure. In addition, so there's a big business opportunity. There's a technology called quantum key distribution. Mm-hmm. If you would like to distribute large quantum keys, then you need dark fibers. Dark fibers is one of the technologies. And utilities do have dark fibers and fiber networks to manage their operational technology and their their networks to control them, to manage them, and for that reason there is a nice opportunity to deploy more dark fibers or to reuse them for quantum key distribution and put a nice, decent business model on top of the current existing models in the energy sector.